मुझे याद आ रहा है, व्हेन आई वाज इन कॉलेज आई वाज वेरी एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट जॉइनिंग द कॉर्पोरेट सेक्टर ओनली जस्ट लाइक यू, कि यार गवर्नमेंट में नहीं जाना है, वहां पे बाबू टाइप फील आती है सोच के. एंड माय फादर यूज्ड टू कीप इंस्पायरिंग मी, नहीं, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट, यू हैव द रॉन्ग परसेप्शन अबाउट गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड गवर्नमेंट बाबूज. Hi everyone, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today I have Saurav Saha with me, who has cleared RBI Grade B examination in 2021. First of all, congratulations, Saurav, on clearing the examination.
Thank you.
I believe this is your first attempt with RBI.
Yes, this was my first serious attempt.
First serious attempt, amazing. So it is a very difficult feat, to be very honest, to clear the examination in first serious attempt itself. And kudos to you on
Thank
having
you.
done this. I know you must have worked very, very hard because luck और बहुत सारी चीजें जो लोग बोलते हैं, those are secondary in nature. कल एक स्टूडेंट के साथ डिस्कशन हो रहा था, one of the students who cleared, and we came to this conclusion कि 99% is your hard work, and that 1% जो एंड में पुश मिलता है, that is your luck, and that is also dependent. लक देखता है कि भाई हार्ड वर्क किया है या नहीं किया है बंदे ने.
Right, right.
Only
Actually,
then it.
I believe luck is second name of confidence. The more you
Yes.
prepare, the more confidence you have, and the luck favors you.
Amazing, amazing. I think you put it succinctly and very, very, very rightly that luck is the second name of confidence. I think all the students should remember this. अपनी दीवार पे भी लिख लो, लिख सकते हो तो, जिससे कि किसी और पे ना ब्लेम कर सको अपने फेलियर को और अपने सक्सेस को. यू पुट इट ऑन योर सेल्फ. ओके, बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, सौरव, कैन यू जस्ट ब्रीफली इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ, टेल ऑल द फ्यूचर एस्पिरेंट्स अबाउट यू, एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चंस.
Okay. Okay. So I did my engineering back in 2010. I did it from Jadavpur University in electronics engineering. Then I worked in IT industry for 2 years. Then I got through CAT. I wrote CAT and I got through it. I did my MBA from IIM Bangalore. I completed it in 2014. Thereafter, I worked in Samsung India Electronics in mobile sales division. I was area sales manager for around 6.5 years. So I left my job just before COVID started. Then I started preparing for government exams, including UPSC and RBI and NABARD and all those things. And so this is the story so far.
Okay, so you left your job in somewhere in 2020 and decided to prepare
yes.
for the examination.
Yes,
उससे
yes.
पहले जो भी UPSC के attempts दिए थे, were these while you were working?
Yes, I gave. So I wrote 3 PSC attempts. Out of that, in one I did not clear because that was the first attempt, and I just wrote it to check the questions and all. Next attempt, I was working, and the third attempt I gave after I left the job.
After you left the job, okay, amazing. So before actually getting into the questions, सेलेक्शन होने के बाद यू वर्क इन ब्यूटिफुल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन योर लाइफ टाइम. सैमसंग जैसी कंपनी में काम किया है, यू मस्ट हैव हैड अ लॉट ऑफ गुड एक्सपीरियंस, गुड यू नो टाइम्स देयर. हाउ डज इट फील, टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, हाउ डज इट फील ऑन गेटिंग सेलेक्टेड इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक आरबीआई?
सो इट इज इट फील्स वेरी डिफरेंट टू बी ऑनेस्ट, बिकॉज सो आई हैड दिस फीलिंग इन द स्टार्ट ऑफ माय करियर दैट आई वुड वर्क ओनली इन द प्राइवेट सेक्टर, बिकॉज आई फेल्ट दैट आई कुड get more growth in private sector. So government or working in the government sector was never in my radar. So after working for 5 and 6 years in Samsung, I felt that because of the situations, I felt that at this point of time, security is more important. And if security gets into an organization which can give the feeling of a private organization, like the efficiency, the role, diversity, and all those things, I think RBI fits perfectly into that bucket. So that's why I chose it.
इससे मुझे याद आ रहा है, व्हेन आई वाज इन कॉलेज आई वाज वेरी एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट जॉइनिंग द कॉर्पोरेट सेक्टर ओनली जस्ट लाइक यू, कि यार गवर्नमेंट में नहीं जाना है, वहाँ पे बाबू टाइप फील आती है सोच के. एंड माय फादर यूज्ड टू कीप इंस्पायरिंग मी, नहीं, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट, यू हैव द रॉन्ग परसेप्शन अबाउट गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड गवर्नमेंट बाबूज. जो जिनसे तुम मिले हो वो
राइट राइट
काफी Yes,
experience
go ahead.
Itself, experience itself, like it influences the decision where to join.
Yes, yes, exactly, exactly. But I think now the government organizations are changing very fast.
Yes,
they are
right,
becoming
right.
tech savvy. They're understanding the needs and demands of young people, and I think RBI to काफी जल्दी चेंज हो रहा है, इट इज एक्सपैंडिंग एंड ग्रोइंग वेरी वेरी फास्ट, सो यू गोइंग टू हैव अ नाइस टाइम. ओके, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग, इट इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी सिंपल, फेज वन प्रिपरेशन. आई अंडरस्टैंड कैट की प्रिपरेशन मस्ट हैव हेल्प्ड, बट देर आर सर्टन डिफरेंट मेथड्स यू नो फॉर दिस एग्जामिनेशन स्पेसिफिकली, सर्टन डिफरेंट थिंग्स दैट यू हैव टू डू, टाइम मैनेजमेंट अलग है, ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर डिफरेंट. हाउ डिड यू गो अबाउट प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर आरबीआई फेज वन?
Yes. So I gave CAT like many years back. It was in 2012. So the pattern has changed drastically after that. So I had to prepare almost from the start, because after preparing for CAT, I almost forgot everything like during this time. The base was also there. So I started my preparation after the notification came out. So after UPSC mains got over, I thought of preparing for RBI. I started preparing. I focused extensively on the online sources. I did not have any like hardware, hard copy books or all those things. There are many YouTube channels. I referred to ADDA 247 for their maths and reasoning. English, I did not refer any sources because I felt I was quite confident in English. So that was the thing for phase one in maths and reasoning. And apart from, so I took almost a week to clear all the like the concepts, to rush up the concepts, the shortcut methods and what are the formulas are there, what kind of questions are coming. Then I started attempting mock tests. So there are many applications as well as online sites where you get daily questions. So I used to attempt that. I think practice mock and olive board and all those things are there. I attempted many free mock tests which is available in Anuj Jindal also. There are two mock tests prior to phase one. So with those mock tests, my confidence got built up. So initially I used to attempt only one caselet in reasoning because of the time constraint, and in on caselet also many things got wrong, but with practice in 15-20 days your accuracy will improve and you will get lot of confidence. So that was about phase one.
Mm-hmm. What about general awareness?
I forgot. So general awareness, so there also I attempted many sources. The main source was the Spotlight magazine, because I did not look at the magazine, to be very honest. I saw the videos, the Spotlight videos that Neha ma'am takes. I revised them multiple times. So I saw those videos. I made Excel sheets, or there is an app. In that app, if you put the questions and the answers, the app will just throw you the question and you have to select the answers from that.
Mm-hmm.
You can make it multiple choice questions from that. So I saw those videos. I fed, so I copied the questions from those videos into the app, and I used to revise them.
Mm-hmm.
So I revised, I guess, 4 months mm-hmm. prior to phase one. And mm-hmm. that was it. I did not see anything else.
Mm-hmm. I think that is more than enough for Spotlight. Four months is more
yes.
than enough.
Yes.
Did you revise or cover phase two current affairs before phase one? I know that यूपीएससी की वजह से वो ऑलरेडी कवर हो रहा था, बट डिड यू स्पेसिफिकली रिवाइज दैट और नॉट?
नो, एक्चुअली फेस टू इफ यू चेक द ईएसआई पोर्शन, दैट वाज काइंड ऑफ रेडी फॉर मी बिकॉज़ आई वाज अटेम्प्टिंग यूपीएससी फॉर लास्ट टू इयर्स. इफ फाइनेंस एंड मैनेजमेंट वाज न्यू टू मी, आई डिड नॉट सी दैट एट ऑल प्रायर टू फेज वन. आई स्टार्टेड इट आफ्टर फेज वन कंप्लीटेड. सो मेनली प्रायर टू फेज वन माय मेन फोकस वाज ऑन quant reasoning and mainly quant reasoning. English was, I was not that much preparing, but these two are the main focus of me.
Yes. Okay, so this is an alert for all the students. Just because Saurav prepared for phase two after phase one does not mean ki aapko bhi wahi karna hai. His educational background is different. His experience is different. His preparation for UPSC also somehow helped. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि उन्होंने वो कम पढ़ा है तो हम भी कम पढ़ के जाएंगे और हो जाएगा.
एक्चुअली आप देखें तो मैंने कम नहीं पढ़ा है.
हाँ,
मैंने एक्चुअली फेस टू का यूपीएससी का जिस हिसाब से मतलब जो भी ईएसआई में क्वेश्चंस थे आई रेड ऑल ऑफ देम प्रायर टू वन ईयर. सो एक्चुअली इफ यू रिमूव द यूपीएससी पार्ट, आई वाज एक्चुअली प्रिपेयरिंग इन ईएसआई फॉर लास्ट वन ईयर ऑलमोस्ट.
यस. तो वो एक साल का जो कवरेज है ऑफ यू नो इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल इश्यूज फ्रॉम यूपीएससी पर्सपेक्टिव, दैट ऑल केम इनटू प्लेड इट्स रोल एंड हेल्प यू आउट. यस. तो या तो यूपीएससी के लिए पढ़ लो एक साल के लिए देन यू, और अदरवाइज आरबीआई के लिए अच्छे से पढ़ लो.
देयर इज नो एनीवेज यू हैव टू स्टडी, एल्स यू विल फॉरगेट. द ऑप्शंस आर वेरी वेरी क्लोज.
यस. यू आर राइट. ओके, लेट्स मूव टू फेज टू नाउ. अच्छा, फेज टू पे जाने से पहले, फेज वन में यू वर टॉकिंग अबाउट मॉक्स. So, yes. Do you remember इन ऑल 10-15 मॉक्स दिए होंगे.
सो फुल मॉक इफ यू टॉक अबाउट, आई गिव अराउंड यस 10 to 12 मॉक आई मस्ट हैव
कितने लिखे
गिवन, बट
होंगे?
आई हां बट आई हैड बट आई अटेम्प्टेड डेली दोस 10 10 10 क्वेश्चंस का जो भी आता है ना, अगर प्रैक्टिस मॉक में आता है या कॉलेज बोर्ड में आता है वो मैं अटेम्प्ट करता था.
Yes, yes. So, did you used to analyze those mocks after attempting those mocks? If yes, how? I think that is a question that I have not asked with anyone else, but I think you would be the right person to answer that.
Yes, I analyze. So, for GA portion, I told you that I used to make Excel sheets, question and answer, and I used to revise them. GA portion is done. Quant and reasoning, I thoroughly revised those things, like any other concept that they must be having, or any other approaches that they must be using. Even if I feel that the approaches which is given in the solution is not, I am not satisfied with that, I used to search in YouTube shortcuts or how to solve this fast enough. And I used to take out whichever is satisfying to me and I used to copy them. So this way I revise those mocks.
Revise those mocks. I think it's very important ki mock dene ke baad you analyze, spend some time on analysis.
Yes, yes.
Identify the weaknesses, why did you not score so well? And you know, overcome those weaknesses.
I think score in mock is, if one should not worry about how much one is scoring in the mock.
Yes.
How much you are attempting and how much you are able to remember into the next mock, that is more important.
That is more important. Yes. So these are like ladders, and you have to keep climbing these ladders one by one after every mock. बहुत सारे students ये गलती करते हैं, एक mock लिखेंगे and then they realize, oh, I just scored 60 out of 200. The top score is 120. I'm not good enough. And then they give up. That happens with a lot of students because they keep doubting themselves.
I think in the first reasoning mock which I took, even after clearing CAT and being from IIM Bangalore, I scored I could solve only one case lead. So it was 4 or 5 marks. That was very bad. So, but one should not get bogged down by the marks. One has to just practice and things will fall into place.
Yes. So this basically tells us ki aisa nahi hai that you know, people who clear are the ones who are always at that level. You have to reach to that level. That's very important. Yes. Okay, let's move to phase two now. ESI, I'm very certain it's only because you were preparing for UPSC. Because of that, you must have covered majority of the things. Other than ESI, finance and management, did you use refers to all your management booklets and all the material before that? Or did you have any other strategy as well?
No. Management, I did not refer to any of my IIM Bangalore notes. They were very much different. Whatever syllabus is given here, it is very concise. So that is a like master's level syllabus. So I should not refer to any, or anyone should not refer to those things. I searched for online notes. I got through your videos for finance and economics, like Basel norms and like banking related things, because those are very new to me. So for those risk, what kinds of risks are there, how many kinds of risks are there, for those I refer to YouTube. One can very well get everything in YouTube.
Yes.
From finance section, even if one is not being able to purchase a course, everything is available for free, so
yes,
one should not be worried about that. So finance I covered from YouTube, from your online channel I refer to EduTab materials as well. And for management I searched. So there is one channel I am forgetting the name. So that guy picks up a topic from the RBI syllabus and he covers it extensively. So there is a playlist. So I can give you in mail after I am completed with the interview. I will give you the channel name. So I refer to that YouTube channel to clear my management content.
There is also a website on management called as Management Study Guide.
Yes.
I have seen that website a lot of times, and that also helps. At least the basics are available there.
Yes.
So yes, I often use
it. But there is one catch there. There are many, many terms. So one can get bogged down by the number. One can get lost.
Yes.
So that is one trap that you have to be aware of.
Yes. So you have to have an idea ki bhai, what do I have to study and what do I have to leave?
Like,
in order to make sure that you're using it properly, right?
With
respect to the descriptive part, was there any difference between how you would write answers in UPSC versus how you wrote answers out here, other than the word limit?
No, first difference is very obvious. There is in UPSC we write offline, So in RBI, there is an online writing. So there is chances of spelling mistakes. One has to be very certain that they are not doing any spelling mistakes. So that is one thing. But apart from that, I think in UPSC, we can do flow charts. We can make graphs. We can make the answer look more interesting. But in RBI, you don't have any facilities to do them. You have to just write. You can maximum do some bullet points with keyboard. That also you cannot do bold or italic. There is no option to do that. So you have to structure your answer in very proper way. In UPSC, the pen is in your hand, paper is in front of you. So you can give gaps and all those things. But in RBI, while attempting the final exam, I found out that if I press two enter, so let's say I am after the first para, I want to give two blank spaces, go to the second para, but that is not possible in the actual app. The next line will start from the next line itself. So those things we have to be aware of from the formatting part. And from the content part, I don't think there is much difference. The preparation was almost the same for UPSC and RBI, for ESI particularly.
Okay, nice. Let's come to English descriptive now. Because in UPSC, you have to write such long essays, but here you have to write such short essays. So was there any difference in the approach that you followed or any specific kind of preparation that you had in mind?
No, actually, in UPSC, I took the essay of RBI like a normal question in UPSC only.
Yes.
Because in UPSC, the essay is like different, 1500 to 2000 words. In RBI, the essay, the word limit is almost matchable to the word limit of UPSC normal question.
Yes.
So I took it as a normal question only. So essay, and I kept it in my mind that in English essay, I do not have to write very much technical things. It has to be very easy flowing. It has to be a very, the reader should feel engaged, like a newspaper report. There should not be many jargons and all those things in the English essay. You can use them in the ESI or finance management essay, but not in, I followed that approach. I don't know whether that is right or not, but I followed that approach.
No, that is very, very right, because I was having a discussion with another, another successful candidate today morning, and we discussed about one essay that he wrote. And the pointers that he told me were very basic in nature. In fact, too basic to be writing out there. But then we felt ki yaar itna basic likhke acha number aa sakte hain, because they're looking for your understanding and your fundamental clarity. They're not looking for any technically savvy answers.
I think for technical knowledge, they are taking it from the ESI and management paper.
Yes.
Anyway.
Yes.
So from English paper, I think they are taking how you are able to communicate yourself. How clear is your communication? I think that is the thing that they are taking in the English paper.
Yes, you are right. Let's come to the interview. The interview, I'm sure, must have been very interesting for you. A lot of experience, a lot of different kinds of environments you've worked in. Any specific questions that you remember that were asked in the interview?
Yes. So in interview, I was very much... So I had a very long work, right? So I passed out long ago. So I was thinking that they might ask why I left the job. And most of the interview, I thought, will revolve around that only. But to my surprise, only the first question came, like, why you want to join RBI? The chairman himself asked the question. And thereafter, they moved on. There was no more question from my work or my hobby or anything else. It was totally technical interview. If I talk about the questions, mainly the questions came from why there is a lot of NPI in banking sector, what are the steps that the bank took to revive MSME, and how can you differentiate a good bank and a bad bank, why a separate bad bank is being created in spite of having some private ARC. So the questions were very much generic, like very much, I will not call it generic, very much basic in nature. So I want to mention in this point that prior to interview, I started reading this Live Mint newspaper. Even before phase two, I did not read the newspapers. I started reading the newspaper after my phase two for the interview, because I wanted to build that opinionated. I want to have some opinions about the current issues. And for the RBI website, I referred to the RBI 247 playlist that you have. I think that is very good. I think I read only speeches from the RBI website. Last two, three speeches, except that I did not refer anything from the RBI website. I think referring RBI 247 is good enough. And in fact, I use many of the things in the interview directly from the video. Like the MSME thing, it was covered in the video. why private, in spite of having a private bad bank, it is being created. That is also covered in video. So I think that helped a lot.
Certainly, certainly. Okay. Before we, I think you've mentioned almost everything that is required to be mentioned for any aspirant. Jinko seriously padhai karni hai aur jinko nikalna hai, I think this much information is more than enough for them to clear the exam. I would also want to bring out one more thing, because we were talking about topics that you can use to prepare on your own. You were talking about using YouTube. In fact, today morning itself, I was working on this. So we have a study plan, which was created last year also and this year also. What happens is normally it gets lost on YouTube among all these videos, wherein in that study plan, I have mentioned all the topics that students can use to prepare on their own. So usme ek exhaustive list bana di hai topics ki according to past year papers and according to the syllabus. And if you want to clear the examination through self-study, you just Google those topics and make your own research. That is more than enough. So we were thinking of putting that on the website, jisse ki students ko easily access ho sake. So I think this is the right time that I can tell students ki bhai wo use kar sakte ho agar aapko self study karna hai. That will also be one of the ways of preparing on your own and, you know, saving your time. That's very important. Yes, yes. Okay. Before we finish off, anything specifically that you would want to mention or you want to talk to the students or say anything out of your experience to all the aspirants out there?
Yes. So this was an experience from directly from the interview. So I like saw many topper interviews last year from your channel, from other channels as well. So many of the interviews, they talked about speeches. That we have to read speeches from the RBI website. So I read the last two or three speeches, I believe, which was there. One was on central bank digital currency. Other one was on, I think, financial resilience. How can we build financial resilience? So if you are like looking out for questions where those things will be directly asked or you can use them directly, you will not get the scope. So I used excerpts from the speeches in my interview answers. Like I directly quoted them. I used them as an anecdote. So they asked me why NPA is not reducing. So I talked about like as per current deputy director Mahesh Kumar Jain sir, lemon problem is there. So that's why NPA is increasing. So I explained it. So I think those things fetched me some marks. So I will ask the students, or even I am a student, I will ask the aspirant, my fellow aspirant, to like what like start reading in a focused way, and whatever you read, try to read them at least two or three times. In that manner, that thing will be in top of your mind, and whenever you will get the opportunity to use them, you will use them and you will get marks for them. So just don't read like hundreds of things. Even if you read 10 things, start reading those, like read those 10 things twice or thrice, so that they can be on top of your mind and you can use them anywhere. So that is one of the messages that I can give them, except that I'm just like one of fellow students only. I'm also learning. So
I remember, I think what you mentioned is very, very correct. In fact, we had a student, Ali, who cleared, I think, in 16 or 17, long time back. And we were discussing once before he cleared and once after he cleared. And he mentioned this to me that I use this technique wherein instead of saying that I believe that NPAs are high because of this reason, I would say, according to the deputy director, sir, SSXYZ, this is the reason that NPAs are rising. So now the examiner or the interviewer cannot counter. And it is more credible also. He believes it much more. So in the interviews that we have had, in the mocks that we have had, humne jahan par bhi mauka mila hai, ye mention kiya hai, ki aap apne aap ka opinion na dein, give out the opinions of respectable people, experts who are in that area. And at the same time, facts can also be used. You must have used some facts also in your interviews. So credibility aati hai aapke answer mein, and their belief and their the impression that they have, that they generate of you is much better, much of a much higher quality.
I think there is also one more angle to it. Like for me, I am an outsider to the banking industry. I have no link to this. So if I can use those things and from the RBI website and data regarding banking and all those things, they will see me as a serious aspirant. They will not feel that I have just like written the exam out of desperation. I have to get a job, and that's why I'm applying. So they might take you more seriously. That plays well.
Yes, I think that's a very good point. It's very important to outshine among those 800 people and to look like a serious aspirant. That is a very, very important point. Yes. Thanks a lot, Saurav, for coming online and sharing all your experiences with me and with all the serious aspirants out there who are also struggling and preparing for this exam. I'm very, very sure that your experiences and your viewpoints are going to help them in a lot of dimensions, in a lot of ways. Congratulations once again for clearing the
Thank
examination. I am certain you're going to have a very nice time and you're going to love the organization. You're going to love working there as
you. I hope so.